Thank you, Honorable Speaker, for the opportunity to speak on this very important issue that is before the House. At a time when the country's financial situation is in dire straits, but
you have nine minutes, Honorable.
Thank you, sir. But before I get on to that subject matter, since the Honorable Minister who preceded me made mention of Tamil political prisoners, I'd like to tell him that this is a matter that we have been agitating for as far as I remember from 2010 when I entered this House. We have not allowed even one session of Parliament pass by without raising that issue. So for over a decade, we have agitated this. In the year 2011, His Excellency Gotabaya Rajapaksa, when he was Defence Secretary, facilitated me to visit prisons and obtain these details of these prisoners, which I did and gave the then President, Honorable Mahinda Rajapaksa. So, for 10 years, this has been talked about. You've expressed interest in doing something. No government ever said, no, we can't release them. But you've kept them for 10 years. Even yesterday, it was strange that a minister from the government is pleading with the government. That's what the statement said. He's pleading with the government to work out a system of release. There was a prominent judge before whom I used to appear, and he used to say this. He would say, if somebody is threatening to mark a document, you can rest assured that the document will never get marked in the case. So if the government is continuously saying, oh, we are going to do it, our suspicion is that they are not going to do it. So without talking, without saying this ad nauseam, release them. What is standing in the way of releasing them? You don't need 10, 11 years to be talking about this. It's quite obvious why you are talking about it now. That's what we pointed out yesterday. There was a statement day before yesterday and before that. The Prevention of Terrorism Act was brought into this country in 1979 for 6 months as a temporary provisions act. Even now it bears that name. I mean, that's how serious it is. It still is called Prevention of Terrorism Temporary Provisions Act for duration of 6 months. It extended in 1982. It was made permanent, but the title remains. When you are on this side, Honorable Dasiri Jayasekara, you have attacked the Prevention of Terrorism Act. You have talked about political prisoners. And today you say you welcome it. Don't just keep welcoming it. Do it. We want to, there is no point of order in that. If you want to reply, you can reply to me at any other time.
Just want to clarify. We never attacked the PTA when we are in the government. We wanted to change it. But the problem is the way it is going to be changed. The clauses that they wanted to put, we don't want to put that. Because the terrorism is somewhat developed now, Speaker. That was the issue.
Right.
You can't let him go on like this. I mean, how much time did you give him? It is not a point of order. As he started, you knew it was not a point of order.
Right.
You couldn't have allowed him to take my time like that. Surely you know what a point of order is. So, all I'm saying is, there is no point in just threatening to repeal it or threatening to change it. Just do it. Show it by your action. Just because some meeting is coming round, some report is due somewhere else, you jump and say these things. But you don't do it. I challenge Honorable Namal Rajapaksa, who said, I welcomed it yesterday without reservation because the government was trying to get a wrong message to the country to say that this is, we are using it like a beggar's wound, and that we want them incarcerated, and that we don't want them released. That is far from the truth. We have agitated this, you know very well. Every session of parliament we have agitated for their release. And because you were trying to send a wrong message, without reservation, I welcomed it. But I'm challenging you, do it. Tomorrow is Poson. Release them. Release some of them immediately with the others that you will release. And release the rest of them immediately. None of them need to be incarcerated anymore. They are political prisoners. We have told you why we call them political prisoners. Honorable Surendra Raghavan went and sat behind Namal Rajapaksa to be seen in the videos yesterday when that announcement was made, and wrote today on social media saying that he played a small part in this. Right? He calls them political prisoners. A person in the government ranks calls them political prisoners. Right? So, they are political. No, no, no. Your name, I will mention your name any number of times. You can't stand up when I mention your name. Right? You have to lick the boots of the government because you have got some position there. Right? Just, I challenge you. Honorable Raghavan, I challenge you. Let's see how many people you are able to release without boasting about this.
Why do you want to get involved in this kind of thing?
Don't play. You are playing. Yeah. You are playing politics.
Both are responsible members of this house.
With prisoners.
Yeah.
Lives. Right? That is what you are doing. You are right? No, you.
Yeah, Mr. Raghavan, can you please
stop it? We are doing this.
You don't need 11 years.
Yeah.
You don't need 11 years. When Sunil Ratnayaka was pardoned, how much time did
you have been in the parliament for 15 years? You have been in the parliament for 15 years. What did you do? What did you do 15 years in the parliament?
That's all right. Now you continue with this.
All right. Yeah. All right. Sit down. Without barking, sit down. Right? I'll say what I did. I haven't been here for 15 years. I haven't been here for 11 years. All 11 years. I said that if you are not listening. Every session of parliament, we have asked for their release. We have done that. We sit in the opposition. We don't go licking the boots of the government and get positions like you. Right? We sit in the opposition and that's all we can do. And we have asked for that. Repeatedly, we don't hang on to coattails of government and get positions. That is not what we do, right? Turncoats like you, right, who don't have any policy. You come and ask us for nomination, then go and get nomination from the government. You don't have any policy.
I would like to ask Honorable Subhandiran, what did you do for last 5 years? Licking the boots of the government. What else? What else he has done?
Right, boom.
Sir, you more than 100 prisoners were released between 2000 and... Please sit down, sir. Right. Tell that dog not to bark.
So, right. Don't get involved that day. Go ahead with your speech.
Behind me.
Why do you want to worry about it?
Now, between 2015 and 2019, more than 100 Tamil political prisoners